We're going to make a simple gooseneck for a small boat here. It's easily made, very cheap. There are lots of goosenecks available, of course, from marine hardware suppliers, but as usual, they're all expensive. They're all in stainless, but if it's just a small boat that's trailered, you don't really need stainless. There's a variety of them, such as this simple one. It just slides into a hole in the boom. This is a fixed one, otherwise it's a fixed position on the mast, has a tack fitting. You can see the price, it's expensive. Here's another one that's similar to that, but it slides on the sail track. $30.25, that's a good few bucks. And here's one that slides in the luff groove, also $30.25. But there's a simpler way of doing this, and here's an example. A very simple one, just slips inside the boom again, fastens to the mast. It's a fixed fitting, that's what we're going to make here. We can reproduce this just with a couple of eyes, an eye bolt, which goes through the mast, and an eye hook, which goes on the end of the boom. I like this type of hook. It's pretty hefty, and I had a lighter one on here once before. This is the mast from Ring-a-Ding, and it bent, so I like this heavy-duty one. Don't worry about the open hook, you'll see a little later on, it's not going to come loose. Obviously the first step is to drill a hole in the mast. I mean, in the boom, I'm sorry. And you want to remount the opening of the hole to take the unthreaded shank. Because if you don't, it's going to be very hard to screw in. But once you can see how far that you need to go in. Once you've done that, however, eye hook will screw in quite easily, except when you get to the bottom of the threaded part, in which case it'll be pretty tight, and you can tighten it up. At that point, you probably need a pair of pliers to do it. But you need to get a good size hole because you don't want to split the boom. This is what we're using here, both the mast and the boom, are two different sizes of closet poles. They come from your local Home Depot or Lousy. That's Home Depot and Lowe's for those who haven't heard this before. But here you are, you can see we've got it screwed in pretty well. We want to go pretty much up to the curve all the way. And then it's pretty well inserted. I like to put in some epoxy around that. It's a little easier to pour into the hole if you can set up the boom vertically. But there's not enough room in the basement to stand an 8-foot boom in, on end. And it's raining outside, so we'll just make do. Spread it out a little bit. We're going to want to put some on the outside of the boom end because we're going to put a seizing on it, which we've done here. This is going to help strengthen the grain. Because there's a good bit of tension on this when it's under sail. So seizing this on some, this is just some regular twine, and snugging it up will provide some additional reinforcement to that vulnerable end of the boom. Once we have this tidied up, I like to coat it with epoxy. That makes it totally unravelable and also very permanent and adds considerable strength. So a good coat of epoxy on the serving, on the seizing, will set it up pretty well. And you can let that dry overnight and you'll be ready to use it the next morning. I use rocker epoxies and overnight is plenty of time for it to cure up fully. Okay. The boom has full motion, full range of motion, up, down, left to right of course, port starboard. I had to set the mast up in the to do this. I had to set the mast up in the hallway, going upstairs, because there's no. It's a 10 foot, a little over 10 foot mast, and there's not enough room in the within the house to do that. This is the mast from Ring-a-Ding. It's also going to be the mast for the canoe-moran I'm going to be doing. That's the 16-foot canoe without riggers, made into a sailing canoe. As you can see, range of motion is good. It can go up as high as it wants. And the nice part about it is this open hook is not a problem, because as long as the boom is horizontal, it's not going to come out. It just doesn't want to come out, so it's secure. And to take the boom out completely, you just drop it down and then lift it straight up. This means that you can brail the mast. Now, brail the boom and the sail up against the mast for temporary furling, and that's very convenient. So the range of motion is complete. And now, our gooseneck, number one, is also complete. Number two and number three will follow.